qualifying Senoia Raceway. We're going to get ready to get the one to go signal. They head off into turns one and two.
Definitely, brother.
Bye-bye. All right, we had one get into the outside wall on the backstretch. So swinging swinger. Got onto the outside back. So out of turns four, they're getting ready to jump to the loud pedal and they're off. So off into turns one and two, they go to zero car, trying to hold on, but here comes Hillman to the outside as they go into turns three and four. Hillman's gonna try a crossover move as he's going for the lead, but can't quite get to him to zero lead lap number one. We got one around in turns four for the number three machine. We stay green flag racing as they're slipping and sliding around the baddest bull ring in the state of Georgia. Your leader trying to hold on, but Hillman, he's gonna change lanes and go up to the top shelf. Down to the bottom, we got a battle for the leads. They head down the backstretch. Hillman's gonna put it down to the firewall. Side by side, out of turn four, good race for the leads. They come to the line. Hillman, your new leader, back off into one and two. Ryan Ray, as he's gonna try to get up in there with Willingham to the outside. Oh, contact for the lead on fours. Those guys pushing to get up there. Back to the strike. The top six are right there together. Coaching out on the back stretch.
Delaware restart. When he hammers the gas, that is when the green flag will be unfurled. And we go back to racing.
Down the back stretch they go as they battle for the second position. Blake Harmon getting out, way getting out of it, but he's going to feel the pressure for the second position.
I'm getting louder.
They battle coming down the front stretch. Back off into turns one and two. Ryan Ray digging down at the bottom, but the high side is starting to have the momentum working in their favor. Down into three and four. Things are going to get hairy in the back, and around they go in turns three and four. So off into turns one and two, they go. Smoking Joe Hillman drops it to the bottom. Look at the third place car, the red, the orange, black. One's gonna get some pressure on Ryan Ray. Side by side on turn four, they battle for the third position. So back off into turns one and two, they go. Harmon holding on second, a good battle for third between a pair of ones. Ryan Ray's down at the bottom. Stevenson's up top, side by side as they continue to square off here on the baddest bull ring. So they continue to race hard. Ryan Ray, multiple time winner here at Senoia Raceway, battling hard with him in the three and four. Top versus bottom, one of the slick tracks. Harmon's gonna get loose and hold on to it. So everybody catfishing down there in Catfish Pond. Great run off the high side for the one machine. Hartman's gonna slide high. Ryan Ray trying to reel in the second place machine. So the field getting sorted out. as we're 11 laps complete. Now complete lap 12, this high by. So Joe Hillman leads, Blake Harmon is second. Ryan Ray third, Shane Tidwell in the T1 machine. Ryan fourth, John Holcomb now worked his way up to fifth. Ted Willingham is sixth to find a car running. Smoking Joe Hillman driving off into the Senoia daylight. At second, third, and fourth right there, trying to make some ground up, but the white flag will fall for Smoking Joe Hillman. So the rest of the field taking the white flag. Joe Hillman leading them down the backstretch. In the Ninja Turtle-looking car, Master Shredder wasn't ready as Hillman's gonna win it tonight. Second goes to Harmon. Third to Ryan Ray. Fourth to Tidwell. Holcomb around out the top five with Willingham running sixth. 11 starters.
So Smoking Joe Hillman picks up his second feature victory of the season as he won back on the 25th of March. And he is your first repeat winner of 2017 in the Hobby Stocks as we had four nights of racing, four different feature victories. So Garrett and Jackson will bring him to the green flag, side by side, nose to tail. If our flag man likes the way they look, he'll throw the green and away we go. Hard down into turn one and two. Garrett down the bottom side and the flag man did not like the way they start, so he throws the caution as the 0-0 car goes around as well.
Here we go out of turn four. They jump to the loud pedal and they're off. So Jim Jackson, Charlie Garrett side by side in the turns one and two as they lunch down the backstretch. We got one putting it in spin cycle in three and four. But Jim Jackson's gonna lead the herd out of four and around goes one and three and four. Three cars getting caught up in it. We're gonna bring the caution out as they complete lap one.
Here at Senoia, I tell you what. Third.
You're right.
Off in the times, one and two, Jim Jackson. Holding the point, but here comes the Godfather, do it right. Harmon's gonna light it up. Out of turn four, great battles, they coming to the line. So the Black 13's up on the Jim Jackson. Side by side for the leaves, they head down the back. Jim Jackson, the Godfather, Daryl Bright. The leaders get loose. What a race here at Smoking. Oh, man, I almost forgot where I'm at. Jim Jackson now to the bottom. The Godfather, Daryl Bright, piping it up down the backstretch. So the Godfather, high, wide, and handsome, 0-4. But don't count out Harmon in the 0-1. He's starting to get into the picture as they go down the backstretch. And the crossover move to the outside. Daryl Bright's back up front, trying to pick up where he left off the last week. As he's going for win number three. In the turns three and four, look at Jim Jackson getting in the mix. Oh, and good God, Duro Bright done broke it down. Something amiss. So your race leader, off the pace in one and two. We say green flag racing back off in a one and two they go. Daryl Bright pulls it back in. So Harmon's gonna pull it back after your race leader as we're halfway in, halfway to go. So Harmon, I'm throwing the hook out, trying to run down your race leader. Good battle for third, and we got a wreck over here in 1 and 2. Out of 4, they get back to the loud pedal. Here we go. Oh, and Garrett spun the tires. Here comes Harmon down to the inside. Jim Jackson getting into it. Garrett's got to get that tail on that loud pedal. Down the back stretch they go. So Tim Harmon's going to lead the fray out of 4. Brand new leader out of Harmon on lap number 9. So Jim Jackson's going to take it to the top shelf. Use that momentum and take it down. Him and Randy Cornwell, former track champion, going toe-to-toe as they battle out of 4. So McKenna now starting to get into the mix. The 14-year-old lady driver trying to run down the third place machine of Randy Cornwell. At the bottom of the speedway, she's up under him for third as they come to the line. So Garrett keeping it tucked down to the very bottom of the speedway. Gets loose, he breaks the traction. Here comes Cornwell and the 00 machine trying to keep the momentum on the young man down. But out of 4, 3 to go this time by. Cornwell, quite the wheel man here at Senoia Raceway, a track championship. Multitudes of wind, the bullhorns are out, 2 to go this time by. McKenna Nams driving hard up on the Cornwell. Garrett's getting loose in front of him. The white flag's out, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th are going to slug it out coming to the records. Your leader's out front, Harmon. A good, strong lead. He dives in and out of 4. Checkered flag for Harmon, Cornwell, and Garrett side by side. Give it to Garrett. 3rd to Cornwell, 4th to McKenna Nams, and 5th to Jim Jackson. So a good race in the Bombers from 2nd on back, but let's hear it up for your race winner.
Tim Harmon, your defending points champion, picking up his first feature victory of the new season.
Jump. Here we go. So off into turns 1 and 2 they go. Todd Brutzel got a slot high. Here comes the mad dog, Mark. Martin again into it. Shannon Anthony to the top side. And a turns 3 and 4. Good geez, these guys are all over the track coming to the line. 32 and lead lap number 1 as they run down the back stretch. The turn up meter is getting down for these boys. Caution out, big hit on the back stretch. Big pile up on the back. Caution out on the speedway. Four car makes up over on the back stretch. As these guys started whipping up the work. And they put it down. downtown of Fireball. The Northeast Nightmare, Shannon Etheridge, making a run after Martin Newt for the lead. Down the back stretch in a 3-4. Side by side. Etheridge to the high side. What a run coming to the line. Shannon Etheridge, the Northeast Nightmare after the Mad Dog. That 21 trying to repeat that KMSA win last year. He's putting a chrome horn to him. Gave him a love tap all four. What a great race. So Shannon Etheridge not releasing up the pressure. He goes down the backstretch. Side by side on four. Martin Newt holding the point coming to the line. So things heating up for fourth and fifth. Sixth, seventh, eighth, right there. Side by side down the backstretch. Oh, goodness gracious, here comes Etheridge. That battle for the lead. Etheridge putting his foot under him. Doing all he can. Wheel to wheel, hub to hub in the turns 3 and 4. The Northeast Nightmare. Whoa, we got a new leader. So he comes flying on turn number two like Jimmy Superfly Snooker. It's all good, brother. So the Northeast Nightmare don't assume control of this feature. So Mark leaked in the black, number one. Battle it out for the sixth position. Trying to get up under him, they head out of backstretch. Oh, and around they go at 3 and 4. Nicholson barely missing him. Faulkner barely missing him. The green flag's back out. Shannon Etheridge gonna head down the backstretch, leading the park over the Mad Dog. Mark Newton down at the bottom. He's trying to find some grip, but the Northeast Nightmare, Shannon's gonna shut away. So Nicholson now up to fourth. He's got a back mirror full of the 51 of Tommy Faulkner. Time running out in this event. As we have came to just a handful of laps to go in this one. Lap 10 is now in. Four laps to go in this feature. Continue to knock these laps off for our minis. The bull horns are out, two to go this time by. The rest of the field's gonna follow suit as they're taking a white flag. Single file throughout the field from this point on. Down out of four, the white rag is out for the Northeast Nightmare. Shannon Etheridge showing out. The pimp hand way too strong on the 21 as he's got to slap him down with a win tonight. Second going to Mark Newton. The rest of the field's going to cross the stripe as we call it a evening in the mini stocks. Super late models getting ready to come up next. So a great showing. Great showing tonight by the Northeast Nightmare of Shannon Etheridge as he goes to Victor Lane here tonight at Senoia Raceway, picking up where he did many times last year.
So Billy the Kid Stevenson, the man out front.
Number four, showing the way. Billy the Kid, the lead lap one.
Look out.
So the big massive field of limited sportsmen screaming off in a one and two. Caution out onto the... And mash it back down to the firewall in the turns one and two. Brandon Bright getting it up on the high side and down the back stretch in the turns three and four they go. Oh, we got one around in turns one and two. They're trying to hang off each other in three and four as the caution waves. 27 cars left on the track, and we're only lap one in the books. Green flag flies. Here we go. So the Whitesburg Warrior, Bled Duke, way up on the top side, getting that thing rolling down the backstretch. Everybody tiptoeing, trying to stay off each other. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Look at that crossover move right there coming to line. In the one and two they go. Drew Larson down there, Curtis Turner. Oh my, hold on, brother, down the backstretch. Those guys pushing on each other out of four. What a race coming to the line. Good run here tonight at Senoia. We'll call it the Senoia Steel Cage Match. Guys are banging off each other. Talking about getting your head rammed up against the wall. That was a hard hit off four. Them guys continue to race and get at it. So back off in a one and two, the field continue to spread out. Four laps in, Drew Larson and the Michael Page setup machine trying to get up under the seven of Mr. Brandon Bright. Brandon Bright having a flawless run tonight, running second. Black Duke just shot out of a cannon up on the top side. In the three and four, the Whitesburg Warrior winding that thing up, coming after turning, they cross the stripe. We got one. Oh, fire up under the hood of Wally McDaniel. So there's a, hey, race fans, back away from the fence area while there's race fans right in front of me. Kids, back up from the fence while there's a fire under the hood.
Those are the dogs.
Billy the Kid Stevens trying to play possum with the field. They jump on the loud pedal. Here we go. So off into one and two, Billy the Kid Stevens trying to hold the point against the 35 machine. He's up under Bobby Arnold, Brandon Bright, Drew Lawson, four wide on four. What a race. Back off into one and two, Brandon Bright to the top side. They're battling three wide for the second position. Curtis Turner in the red 68 trying to get under the blue and white 14 of Drew Lawson. The Whitesburg Warrior, Bled Duke hanging it wide, wide and handsome, trying to hang up. And we got a look trouble over there in turns three. We got one around in turns three. Right at the bottom of the speedway. So the hammer is dropped and they're back at it. Off at a one and two. Oh man, four wide on turn two. Hang on, Nelly. We got a showdown coming out of four. The 35 of Bobby the Wild Child is out front. So Billy the Kid Stevenson gonna fall back to second. We got one around in turns one and two. So we got two around in turns one. Oh, maybe an accordion effect in turns three and four. Everybody good. So Cheeseburger, Jeff Carter putting it in spin cycle over there in turn. All right, time has ran up and expired. Oh, and we got one around on the back stretch. They're going to wave this off. They're going to wave this off. All right, here we go out of turn four. They put it down to the firewall. Here we go. It's off into turns one and two. Smoking Brandon Bright. Richard Goo, Billy the Kid Stevens trying to get three wide. They head down the back stretch. Richard Goo getting the X39 stuck up in there. Hard battle for second coming to the line. The white rag is out. Smoking Brandon Bright trying to hang some up there. He's coming after the Wild Child. This is going to set up for a shootout. Out of three and four. And give it up, Bobby Arnold. He picks up the win. Richard Goo third, second Brandon Bright. Fourth to Drew Larson. And Bill, oh, excuse me, Blant Duke coming home fourth. And Billy the Kid Stevenson rounding out your top five.
Ashton Winger, Marty Lunsford. Two very competitive young guns in our great late model division. Matt Black, Dennis Likens behind. The green will fly, here we go. Winger's hard on the gas, Matt Black trying to in the inside. Lunsford will settle in on the high side, charging down through three as Likens way up top in three. Kyle Cochran, Jamie Maurice side by side, almost locked together, welded together maybe on a turn four. Likens and Craig Scott doing a flip-flop down the back straightaway, swapping inside and out. Solid competitive racing all the way through the field as Ashton Winger leads the parade. Lunsford has settled into second. Marty Lunsford has struggled all season long, trying to put the pieces together for a solid run here tonight. Matt Black running third. Likens in the fourth place position. Craig Scott sixth. Maurice seventh. Bobby Mills eighth. Cochran and Knowles in ninth and 10th. Ashton Winger is going to get into lap traffic here very shortly. Then we'll see if he's got the mustard to stay out front of Marty. Matt Black holding steady in third. Lankins in fourth as everybody's fighting for position behind. The car that's on the move in the top 10 is Fling Dylan Knowles in the 66 car. As Winger is now in the lap traffic passing Tia Johnson and putting Mike Abercrombie in his crosshairs.
As the racing continues around the Speedway, Air Force Ashton checking out on the field right now. You got Marty Lunsford, a big run for him as he runs in the second position. Screaming around with these GM Performance 604 crate engines under the hood. Great racing all around the Speedways, guys, using top, bottom, middle, trying to find that little bit of grip, but Air Force Ashton showing away tonight in the turns one and two. 12 laps complete. Eight to go as he rockets off turn number four. Guys driving like the pros tonight. Craig Scott putting on a great show, running third. Dennis Lykins back there in fourth. Excuse me, Matt Black in the Black 00 machine running in the third position with Lykins in fourth. Two young drivers doing a fantastic job up front. Oh, hard contact between Maurice and Copeland in 95. They get back shaped up and running down the back end of three and four. So the Brooks Bandit of Jay Southwell now sits in the way. Caution, oh, turns three. Marty Lunsford locked in hard behind the lap cars. The bullhorns are out. Excuse me, three to go so far in this feature. We're going to see the bullhorns, two to go this next time by. Marty Lunsford still. Oh, here comes Matt Black. On the outside, Marty's going to shove the lap car out the way. Move over, brother. I got company and I need to get on through somewhere. Not much time left in this one. The white flag is out for Air Force Ashton. What you gonna do when Ashton runs wild on you? The crowd getting to their feet as the young phenom driver is gonna take home win number three tonight. Second going to Marty Lunsford. Third to Dennis Lykins. Fourth to Matt Black.
So Ashton Winger continues the streak. Four straight race nights. But Winger has picked up the feature victory here in the crate late model division. Marty Lunsford, his best finish of the season. The 25th of March, he took home the limited late model feature. So far this season, Dooley has two feature victories in the limiteds. Horton has one, and Drew Collins, the Auburn Assassin, also with one feature victory in the Limited. So we'll see if we have a new driver to visit the Robert and Sons Aluminum Victory Lane or a returning driver here tonight. 20 laps and we'll know the answer. Wild start as they go four wide down the front straightaway. Magic Matt powering out. Nope.
Smart Ben.
Nope. Armistead and Williams row three. Here we go. Joey Armistead using that low line to jump some spots there. Come on, turn four as the green flag flew. But out front, it's Austin Horton using that topside momentum to snare lead on lap one. Doyle settle into the number two spot with Armistead working the inside. Jason Williams and Bailey Williams right behind them. Said who have battled out the past two Saturday nights are battling it out again here tonight. Joey on the inside, Dooley on the outside. As they wage war against one another, trying to chase down Austin Horton at the same time. Caution comes out for Chris Carr as Carr goes the wrong way in turn one. Jason Williams making a strong charge as he goes past Bailey Williams on the outside to snare fourth place. And now he'll set his sights on Dooley as he tries to climb through the field.
Get back to the race.
Oh, look out in front of the field. They're all going to pile up down the back straightaway. As the big one happens here at Senoia Raceway.
Is that the big one?
That is the big one, at least for tonight.
Like donkey.
Armistead puts the squeeze play on Horton to take over the lane as Williams goes around. So Armistead quick on the trigger on the restart. So Michael Turner having a hard time. Making that topside work again here Saturday night. Austin Horton trying to hold that lead down on the inside, but Dooley working his magic for the third straight wake has caught up to Austin Horton as they go near side by side down the back straightaway and into three. Great run out of turn two, and he's going to put him down behind him. And Horton will fight back through three and four side by side at the line, and Dooley will lead lap 11. Horton trying to fight back, but Dooley has the car right now. Austin fights back as they're side by side through one and two. They continue side by side down the back straightaway. Great race between two great young drivers here at the Bullring. Michael Turner, the lap car, who's going to use him for a pick? Will it be Dooley getting Austin behind him, or will it be Horton trying to shove Turner up the track and pick Dooley off? When they come to the flag stand, the bear horns will be out. Two laps to go. Horton still trying to find room on the inside. Turner's going to be in the way. Can Austin Horton reel in Dooley here in the last lap and a half as the white flag will fly as these leaders come out of turn number four. Now Chris Carr up top, and Dooley's going to have him. He'll cut down in front of the leaders. Almost a dead heat at the line, but Dooley will get the advantage. Here comes Horton now. Horton slides up the track. They touch just a little bit at the line. It's going to be Austin Horton. A great race. A great battle between two fantastic young drivers. Magic Matt Dooley will finish second tonight. Austin Horton beats him out of the final turn and inches in front at the line for his second feature victory of the season. 15 laps to finish up tonight's Spring Fling presented by Special Olympics Georgia.
Hey, did you get your money?
I'm going to go with the odds here. I'm going to pick a dark-colored car.
Pretty good shot. 48 coming in. 87.
Green flag goes, and the hot shots are underway. Geo Prism of Williams. Oop, starts to slide around, but Williams will lead lap one. Oh, look at that. Little body slam. Everybody keeps going the right way, though. That's hot shot racing for you right there. Just got to go up, plow your way through the field. '66 car of Dean Williams got out for a Saturday night cruise. So he's got a half a lap lead over the 87.
Guys catching up with the
tail. Halfway home, halfway to go for Williams. Dueling fives for third and fourth place. Let that confuse you for a minute. Shane Davis, Michael Fulmer battling it out right behind the 87 car of Little. So they thought about three wide for just a moment. Michael Fulmer, last week's feature victor, trying to work on Little here coming out of turn four as Williams is about ready to lap the entire field. White flag comes out for Williams in the Geo Prism. Williams will be your winner, your final winner of the night. As the battle now looks like it's for third, fourth, and fifth. as Fulmer will come across second, and here's the race for third. So the hot shots complete the night's racing. And that will be it for tonight. The Spring Fling is in the books for 2017. Don't forget, next Saturday night, another night full of excitement. The Cajun Mini Stock Association will be here. The Super Late Models, the Limiteds, the Crates, Late Models Sportsman, Hobbies, Bomber Cars, and these Hot Shots will all be racing with us next week, 2 weeks from tonight, the Late Models.